Chemistry. Welcome back, everybody, and today we are reacting to Kelly Clarkson's new album, Chemistry. I've been waiting for a little while for this album, ever since I reacted to the first two singles out of the 14 tracks that we can find on the album, the two being Me and Mine, that are found at the beginning of the album. If you want to check out that reaction, I'll be putting the link down in the description. But otherwise, I'm really excited to get into this, so without further ado, let's get into it.
Can I skip this part? What it's gonna take to get me through this break is no good. I'd like to skip this part.
Such a common feeling.
I'd like to skip this part.
I mean, it's crazy how definitely it sounds like an introduction to the album, but at the same time, it's a full song. But it was such an interesting production that it didn't feel like it was a whole song. Like it went by like this, and I mean, it's true to Kelly Clarkson, her sound. That is exactly what you expect from an opener that is about the end of a relationship and a divorce, and it's going to be a truth-telling album. It sets the tone perfectly. It's a bit of a heavier song, and I feel like a lot of the tracks, maybe not all of them, but a lot of the tracks will be heavier. It's not the type of pop music that she made many, many years ago. It's a grown-up, here's the truth, here's my version of the story type of album. But there is the storytelling aspect that is very strong in that track, and that sets the tone for the rest of the project. I haven't heard Mine and Me in a very long time. I think that I tried to purposely avoid listening to the songs again so that I could kind of forget them and be more in the surprised mood as I'm listening to the album. To be honest, I don't quite remember what it sounds like, but here we go, we're jumping into it.
They cross a line and steal your shine like you did mine.
I like her voice so much. The hi-hat is so clean on that track. It's so well mixed. And it's definitely live instrumentation, which is different than most, especially nowadays.
And you keep talking, it'll come back. Cause our heart can be used like you did mine.
I mean, what can you say about that? Definitely, okay, well, what I can say about that is that I feel like the interlude, if we're gonna go in the storyline of the album, definitely the interlude is a part that is a, hey, let's go back in time, and I wish I could skip everything that I'm about to talk about, but it did happen. So I think we're back at the beginning, or the downfall of the relationship, and we're gonna go through time, that we're going to go through the time with the stages of grieving and the different steps of how that whole relationship came to an end and the aftermath.
My mother showed me to become strong.
Ooh.
Before your own needs, it's not a bad.
Okay.
When I don't feel it, no, I don't feel it.
I love how 80s sounding it is, with the synth and the toms really being present. I didn't expect it to go in that direction that early on in the album. I thought the sonically the album would be a little more stable. I was so caught off guard by the sound of the track that I didn't pay attention to the lyrics at the beginning. So I'm just gonna do that right now. Put the others first before your own needs. I mean, a lot of moms, unfortunately, kind of show that to their kids, which is not necessarily healthy, but I mean, so many moms have put their children and the rest of their family before their own or themselves. And I walk the high road where nobody else has tread. I think, okay, so that song is definitely about making that decision to get a divorce. And A, entourage, because she's from the South, it's probably a very conservative entourage that she has and family members and whatnot. So being one of the first ones to kind of initiate a divorce and to break the ice on that reality, drawing back on inspiration or images of youth, motherhood, older generations, and the change in time, which is interesting now that I think about it, because it's an 80s sounding song and we're talking about practices that are older, like an older mentality, something that's based on older traditions. So that's kind of fitting, actually, now that I think about it. It's really poetic as a choice of style for that song. So everybody thinks I'm a hero. Yeah, I don't need this. I really like how that third chorus really changed up in terms of lyrics. It shows a change of state of mind with regards to the next step in the journey in the story. And it shows the evolution of, like, I went from I'm not being happy, I shouldn't be doing this, I have not been brought up this way, to, you know what, this is the time to do it, I'm not going to fake it anymore, and I'm just going to perform that change in my life because I'm tired of, you know, pretending to keep everything good together and doing it for the sake of other people instead of myself. I actually really like it. It's so such a throwback type of sound, and the mixing was really well done on that one too. She does like a lot of, like, obviously she's a great vocalist. The only thing I've noticed so far is that there is a strong trend in the way she approaches it vocally, like, as in she always has that climax at the end of the song with that one high note. I'm sure it's not gonna stay like that for the rest of the album, but I'm curious as to how she's gonna change it up in the next couple of tracks. I don't need somebody to hold me. Don't need somebody to love me when I got me. You're the one with secrets. Don't need somebody who feels weak standing next to me. Out of the two singles that came out at the very beginning, I think this one was my personal favorite. I feel like having that choir in the back is just bringing out exactly what works with Kelly Clarkson, which is that storytelling meets soulful energy and vocal talent. Like, these are the three main elements that just, like, come together in a freaking meeting board room and just, like, today we're gonna do something with it and we're gonna work together to make the best project ever. And this is what it gives. This is exactly what the result is. And I think that it's probably to me the strongest song out of all four tracks that we've heard so far. I heard you started running your mouth again. Biting hands that feed you. A little birdie told me you're nobody's friend. And the joke's on me. Eat somebody who can meet me well. It's so weird. I was not expecting that switch up, but I was also expecting it at the same time. Like, I found the beginning so simple that I was like, yeah, there has to be more. There just has to be more. And there was more. And also, try him. Like, yeah. The lyrics are so honest and straightforward, and I think she had enough of the BS to, like, completely be truthful about the situation. I'm liking that energy for her. I'm liking that energy for her. Saw this coming, but I didn't want it to end. The synth is really interesting on that one because it sounds like a really deep guitar note. Anyway, it's not a synth that I hear very often in music. So I like how daring that is. It's a very different sound. It sounds like a guitar, like, string-based instrument. I tried to be your friend. Oof. You can't bring me down to you. Ooh. Okay. That sounds a lot more like the pop Kelly Clarkson from previous projects. Kind of a little bit of a throwback type of sound. Yeah, definitely a strong presence of guitars so far in the album. which I like. It's much more on leaning towards the rock side than it is on any other genre, like specifically. It's an overall like really decent track. I like it, but I'm definitely, I have a feeling that some of the heavy hitters are to come, especially in the second half of the album, and we're only on track 5. Chemistry, the title track of the album. Ooh,
I found out I needed as the curtain's calling.
Just the fact that she's going back to her country roots for the song, I feel like this one is gonna hit in the feels.
You know chemistry, it can sneak up on ya. Can't help but want you, help but love you. How'd you get in?
Oh, okay. I didn't think that was the direction at all that this song was going to take. I think I heard an interview somewhere where she was saying how chemistry can be, you know, obviously good as much as it can be bad. It makes you go back to things because of, you know, familiarity and good feelings. And I think this is what the track is about specifically, where she might have gone back to him. Which, I mean, a story is never a straight line. Otherwise, it'd be really, really boring. So I didn't expect this at all at this, especially this early in the album, but it makes sense. I mean, not a lot of stories that I've heard don't have somebody going back to the other person for a second try or something.
You know I've gotten really good.
Ooh, wait, hold on.
You know.
Oh, this is really cool. This is really, really cool. I think that they took a guitar sample and put it backwards, and it's definitely like a metaphor for going back in time and trying to, you know, get back the feelings that there used to be. That is really smart. Good job, whoever produced that one. I have chills.
I stay away cause around you my heart breaks.
I love how dreamy it sounded at the end. There's something about that desire to go back to find familiarity, even though you're just digging at something from the past that is, what's the right word? Ephemeral? Hold on. Yeah, exactly. Ephemeral is the word that came up to me, because it has that storytelling element, that kind of like through the haze, cloudy judgment, breaking reality for a second type of feeling to it. Oh, that song encapsulated that perfectly. Wow, I liked it. Oh. Oh, whoa. Wow, that was a complete fail. I was fully expecting it to like have a drop and repeat the chorus a second time with like a beat, which I'm assuming is going to happen in the second chorus. Watch it happen. I think one of the most precise example and very like definitive example of that is Lady Gaga's, how's it called? Woman. Is it just Woman? Hold on. Free Woman. There you go. Free Woman really has that moment in the first chorus where it, oh God, I'm sorry, my eye. I don't know what I did, but it started like crying and burning. Okay. Am I good? Yeah, okay. Free Woman after the first chorus, it kind of dips like that and goes back into the second, well, back into a verse. And so you kind of have that feeling where it's about to drop and it doesn't, and you're left hanging. That's exactly what just happened here, which is, it just, you know, it might have misled me a little bit. Just a little bit. Made a fool of me, that's for sure.
You're my favorite kind of high.
Oh, that's a cool little effect. That belt, I don't know what that note was that did to me. hold on, that didn't even make sense at all grammar-wise. Let me take that back. I don't know what that note did to me, but it just hit some, it struck a chord, no pun intended. I don't know what she did in that note. I don't know if it was like, oh, why am I still crying? Oh my God. I don't know what she did in that specific note, but it pulled something different out of me. Interesting. Okay. Definitely such a fun song to bop to. I didn't expect it to go in a very upbeat direction at this point specifically in the album. You know, if you look at the five stages of grief, she's definitely in the denial phase. Hold on. I don't even know what the order is. Five stages of grief. Okay, well, denial is technically the first. So she came to this realization that she's having this like struggle, and now she's probably in the denial phase before any of the other phases that she's about to go through. And I think we're gonna go through a wild ride in that second half. And that is my prediction. Watch me be wrong. I feel like it happens all the time, but I think that she's at this point, and that denial is why it's so upbeat, right? It's compared to the whole situation. Even though my heart is weak. Can somebody tell me why I thought there was going to be like a trap beat over that? That would be an amazing sample to just like put a trap beat and have a rapper on that. For some reason, I was secretly down below. Down below? What the fuck? Oh my God. That triggered some reaction out of me. That's so funny. I was secretly hoping that it would actually be like a trap song. That would have been such a curveball. Obviously, totally out of place in the album, but that would have been a really funny curveball. And one day this rhyme might make you smile. Please believe in me. It's magic, my love. It's very cinematic and kind of like Taylor Swift-esque. Like, I don't know if you, especially the chorus, the way that it's written, like the melody, it really sounds like a Taylor Swift track, or at least that is my referential, but definitely very, very cinematic. I would dive into your deep, laying at your feet. Good bridge. Solid bridge. I like the production on this one. Once again, very movie-esque, very cinematic, very second chance giving, let's turn this around type of situation. Now I'm really thrown off though. Like, we're at track number 8 past, that is the first song past midpoint. Where is it going? Where is it going? I don't know where it's going. I'm so confused, lover. Same. Now our story's just a page. What good's a lighthouse when the light is burning up? Ooh, that's so visual. And I feel what we were washing over me, questioning everything all the time. Tried and asked me to change, as if I could do that. Burning out. Okay, that one got a little bit in my feels. It was kind of cool though. At the end, there was a high, like, falsetto note. I don't think it was quite whistle, but definitely falsetto. That made it sound a little bit like a mermaid. That visual of a mermaid in water with like the storm happening and the lighthouse light burning out. I love how visual that song was and how emotional it was. Even though it wasn't like, it's a not a power ballad, but it's not a soft ballad either. It's a storytelling ballad. It was whoa. Well, apparently it hit me so hard in the feels. Lighthouse that I can't even speak properly. Fantastic. But to finish what I was saying, it's really, the song's really good. You were my Rock Hudson. It was real, but it wasn't. Okay, hold on. I don't even know what that means, Rock Hudson. So let me just look it up what that means. Oh, American actor, one of the most popular movie stars of his time. Prominent heartthrob in the golden age of Hollywood.
Guess it didn't, you just fooled me. Who knew love was so confusing? No, I won't dance anymore.
Wait a minute, is that a reference to Piece by Piece, her song that she wrote? By the way, Piece by Piece, I found out the... No way! By the way, Piece by Piece, I found out my hero's me. Yikes! Wow! Ouch! For anybody who doesn't know, Piece by Piece, the song that came out from the album Piece by Piece, I believe, is a ballad where Kelly refers to her father that was absent in her childhood and came back later, probably just to profit off of her success. And I think from memory, because that literally that song scarred me. It made me cry so many times just from watching it. And I say watch it because if you're a Kelly Clarkson fan, you know that that performance on American Idol of Piece by Piece, a cappella, by piano, while she was pregnant, fully hormonal, and then what's his face, freaking crying the whole time, Keith Urban, and then J-Lo with her watery eyes, it gets to me all the time. I cannot not cry when I see that performance. It's impossible for me not to cry when I hear that. It gets to me. I don't know what it is about that performance. It just gets to me. In the song, she says, piece by piece, I restored the faith that you have. I know the song by almost by heart because I've been, like I said, I was scarred. I was scarred. Like, I'm truly, truly scarred. Oh, no, hold on. Piece by piece. And something like, he won't leave her like you left me. Oh, I need to get the lyrics right because my God. He collected me up off the ground where you abandoned things. Piece by piece, he filled the holes that you burnt in me at 6 years old. He never walks away. He never asks for money. He takes care of me because he loves me. So this song was saying how she met somebody and she was with somebody who was 1,000 times better than her own father. Now, fast forward to this song, Rock Hudson. It finishes on piece by piece, I found out my hero's me, not my significant other. Whoa. That's wild. That you could never even read. No, I won't dance anymore. Piece by piece. I found out my hero's me. Wow. I have nothing to add. I literally have nothing to add. See, I think though that we are in the anger chapter of the process of grieving. So we're moving forward. We're going along on that little path, on that little journey.
Imagination's acting up again. Must have been my mistake. Before I heard you say, the night our home became just a house.
The way our home became just a house. There is something so hard-hitting about the imagery of home. Like, just the idea of home, and especially when you're in a relationship and you're building a home together and losing that sense of home.
Why don't you come say what you wanna say? Your heart are pretty close, but you need a space.
Shit. Ouch. Oh, I didn't expect that. You hold her pretty close, thought you needed space.
Always.
First of all, title Red Flag Collector. Second of all, Western cowboy type of situation. Me and cowboy stuff. Wait, that's That does not sound right at all. What I mean is, like, cowboy inspired music. Most recent reaction being the song by Sabrina Carpenter that I am currently forgetting. I'm gonna ask editor Zach to pop it right here. She referred to herself as the red flag collector. Ah, ouch. But hey, self-awareness, good for her. That was a fun ride. No pun intended. Sonically, oh my god, I haven't really talked about the last few tracks from a, you know, production perspective. Definitely, this is fun because we all know, well, we maybe all, not all, no, but it is common knowledge that rock music is a derivative of country, or at least part of the same family, and it just developed over time. So for the song to start off with a country vibe and go into rock, it's like a natural evolution. So it definitely fits, and it's an interesting mix from a production perspective. I don't know what came first, actually. The lyrics or like the musical production? I guess we won't know for now. We really said, let's go back to Yeehaw Days. Is the whole album end gonna be like that?
It's a bitch sometimes. Mama, I'm sorry for using that word. Why do you smell so good? You know I love that cologne. Counting your blessings on my back. Living your best life, living fast life. You're out.
Woo!
I hate love.
It's the second track that starts off with a very country vibe and then goes into more of a rock vibe. And I think that goes to show the versatility that Kelly has when it comes to sound, and it fits her, it suits her so well. I only realized towards the end of the chorus that we had transitioned into another sound.
It's complicated, it's more like what happened, so you can keep Gosling and I'll take Steve Martin. I hate love.
That is so cool. And The Notebook, the movie, lied. And It's Complicated is more like what happens, so you can keep the Gosling, the Ryan Gosling from The Notebook, and I'll take Steve Martin from It's Complicated. Aw, that is so funny and so sweet.
Why does it hurt so much when you know it's the right thing?
I don't know if Steve Martin comes up and actually sings, but the song and the content has such a comedic type of approach that it just naturally makes sense to have somebody like Steve Martin on the track. It just adds to the fun element of the joke and the sarcasm.
Love, I'm empty now, so I'm tapping out.
Last track of the album. That's right. I mean, that's how it's called. That's right.
I ain't your little girl. You're confused and I've lost patience. You and I really means whatever you want. I let you go with the tide. That's right.
Okay, hold on. I did not expect. Cool. I did not expect a clothing song like that, and then I was really surprised when I heard this like reggaeton beat, definitely like island vibes, and I was like, whoa, this really stands out from the rest of the album sonically. And then I was like, but why? Just like what was the reason, you know?
What was the reason?
And then there's all those references of beaching. Am I okay of going to the beach and enjoying that experience of dipping your toe in the water of, you know, the beach? That apparently is not an activity that her ex liked. Now it all ties in. Now it all makes sense. I was really caught off guard at the beginning, though.
I let you go with the tide. That's right.
It really sounds like a victory song.
That's right.
That was definitely, I mean, for sure that the songs were in order, like in chronological order, or almost 100% of them were. It really, we could follow a storyline of that anger at the beginning, then that phase of hesitation and going back to her now ex in the middle, and then all these realizations towards the end and that bitterness at the end leading to walking away and finally accepting. Well, no, I wouldn't say that the album has the accepting part. That's not true. But definitely, like, this is settled. I've made up my mind chapter. The album goes to show how versatile Kelly Clarkson is when it comes to sound and style. We've heard many different sounds. We've heard soulful. We've heard like islandy. We've heard rock. We've heard country. We've heard pop. It's a beautiful representation of all the different feelings and episodes that you live in the downfall of a relationship. The storyline ties everything together. Usually, I think that's often what happens. You either have albums where the thread through all the songs or most of them is, or it is the storyline. And in this case, the thread was the storyline. That was a great project. I really enjoyed it. This was fun to listen to, and there's definitely multiple songs that I gravitate to naturally. Well done. I think honestly that is a mature, well-executed approach to discussing the theme of divorce and the end of a relationship. I don't know, it didn't feel like a traditional breakup album. It really felt like a divorce. I think that's the perfect nuance. It didn't feel like a breakup, it really felt like a divorce. It sounded like a divorce. It sounded complicated, it sounded intricate, it sounded uncertain, it sounded smart, thought through. I really, really, really enjoyed this project. It was a good one. So this is my ranking of the song, from the one that I loved the most to the one that I gravitated to maybe a little less. Honestly, there weren't any bad songs or songs that I didn't like. They really all had a little something special about them, and that makes it an overall like great project that I thoroughly enjoyed listening to and definitely will be going back to in the near future. I hope you guys enjoyed my reaction as much as I enjoyed listening to the album. Do not forget, please, 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 to subscribe, leave a comment, give a thumbs up to the video. Honestly, I love reading your comments and interacting with you guys. I hope you can tell by the way that I actually answer and on previous videos. If you go through the comments, I really enjoy exchanging with you guys in those comment sections. I'll see you in the next video. Take care.